Welcome students. Today during our class we will study about work and energy. In this chapter we will go in detail what is the
concept of the work and how work has some relation with the energy. So let's start with the topic that is work. What does it mean? So work is defined as the product of force and displacement of an object in the direction of the force. It means that when we apply a force on any type of the object and this force displaces the object through S, then it is said that some amount of work is done. So we calculate work done by using this formula, that is F. Here it will be dot, F dot S. This is the force in Newton and the displacement is S. So here is the example. If this cart is at this place, you have applied a force and you have displaced it up to this point, and after displacing it, basically you have done some work. The unit of work is joule. Again, another way, if you are asked to define the work and you define work like it is the dot product of force and displacement, and it is a vector quantity at the same time. And if anybody asks you how will you calculate the work done, so this will be your formula to calculate work done. And here it is basically dot between the two, F dot S. It is F and it is dot product of S and displacement, force and displacement. So this is the mathematical formula to calculate. Then we will see what is the unit of this work and how it is defined. Let's move forward. It is definition is when we apply a force on a body and the body covers a displacement in the direction of the force, then we say that the work is done. So this is the definition of the work done. So work is a scalar quantity. Why? Because whenever you are trying to explain someone that 10 joule, 20 joule amount of work is done, look, there is no indication, there is no any clue for the direction. So that's why it is a vector, it's a scalar quantity. And it's the dot product of two vectors. And dot product is always a scalar product, because at the end, you are not getting any clue, any type of the direction about along with that quantity. So here it is. It is denoted by W. And then the product of force and displacement in the direction of the force is work. Mathematically, it is written like this one. You have seen that it is the dot product of force and displacement. And here, this is the formula to calculate the work done. It is the dot product of force and displacement. This is the formula. If you write on the unit from this place, unit of force is Newton and unit of displacement is a meter. So it means that its direction is unit meter, Newton meter. So we will define its unit as well. So this is the second definition of the work done. So if we move ahead, it is another example. If you are applying, this one is the displacement, you are applying a force, and if you apply a force on a block, you displace it through such displacement and new position, you place it up to new position. At that time, you are applying a force, and if you resolve that force into its component, the vertical component, this one will be sine theta, and what about this one? It will be fx. This one will be f cos theta. So here it is. If you look at this one, is fx. Mean this is horizontal component, and this one which is in upper direction, that is basically fy, and this is called horizontal component. Sorry, this one is fy and it is called vertical component of the force, and this one is fx, it is called horizontal component of the force. So the component along which, if you are standing inside your classroom and you are trying to drag or move a rostrum up to a certain displacement, then the easier it will be if you move along the horizontal direction. So easily you can move. And with other mathematical proofs, you will come to know, you will understand that the work is done only with the dot product. And during dot product, we use cos theta. Basically, we use the component of this force along which it becomes to perform work more and more easier. If you are asked to move from this point, this one, this point, up to this point, so if you are applying vertical force, it's not possible. It becomes difficult. But if you apply a force from this point to the direction of this point, so it becomes more easier for you. So that's why we use dot product in case of work done. But we use for the cos product to calculate other types of some physical quantities like torque, and that fits in that formula. But here we use the dot product. Why? Because the work, it is easier to perform some work in the direction of the displacement. In the direction of the displacement, angle will be zero and cos zero is one. So it mathematically it is proven that the maximum amount of work is done when we apply a force along the direction of the displacement. So here it is. When there is an angle theta between the two force and displacement, then what will be then? F work done is F as cos theta, and the unit of work done is joule. Physics concept of work. So if you look at, this is the basically work can be calculated by using taking the dot product between the two force and displacement. And again, we use this one, not cross, but it is a dot between the two, F dot S. Then S a unit of work is joule. It is equal to Newton meter. The S a unit of the work is joule. Look at formula. We always write on the physical unit of a physical quantity by using the units of all the other physical quantity. That is, force unit is Newton, displacement unit is meter. So one joule is equal to Newton meter. So let's start from this point. If anyone asks you to define one joule, place one with each quantity, physical quantity. If you look at, start with the sequence, how much force you will apply, you will start with the force, and then you will see the body is covering some displacement. At the same time, you will be able to indicate that how much amount of work is done. So let's start with the force. You are having 1 Newton force, and this force produces displacement of 1 meter. Then it is said that one joule amount of work is done. So this is the definition of a 1 joule. 1 Newton force applied on a body and displaces it through 1 meter, then 1 joule amount of work is done. So here it is. If you look at, a person is dragging, he is making an angle of, is the string which is connected with a cart is making an angle of 30 degree along the horizontal, and he is asked to calculate the work done. He will resolve it, and then finally he will be able to calculate. More he decreases the angle, more it will be easier to drag. More he increases the angle, even if he moves and if he applies the force up to the 90 degree, he will be unable to move the displacement in the cart. Why? Because cos 90 is zero. No amount of work will be done. No amount of displacement will be covered, which is required to move in this direction. So that's why amount of work done is linked with the angle. And by using the value of angle, it becomes more easier for us to calculate the amount of work done. So what is joule? I have already explained. Once again, we will see definition. This is the definition of the work is done, said to be done if 1 joule. If a force of 1 Newton is applied to the displacement, to displace it up to 1 meter in the direction of the force, then it is said that 1 joule amount of work is done. So here it is. Mathematically, 1 joule, 1 Newton, 1 meter. And 1 joule is equal to Newton meter. If anyone asks you, Newton meter is equivalent to, then it is equal to 1 joule. So here it is, the component. This one component is basically, if you resolve this force into its component, this is F cos theta and this one is F sine theta. We are only concerned with the direction component of the force, which is in the direction of the displacement, which is responsible to do the work. That is F cos theta. So that's why we use cos theta. And if we are only concerned with force and displacement, then it will be dot here. But if you replace with the angle, there is no need for the dot. So this is the reason why we use cos theta between the two. So here it is, when the work done will be maximum, when it will be minimum, and when it will be zero. work done will be maximum if the angle between force and displacement is zero. So work done will be maximum. This is the maximum amount of work done. And when it will be minus or the negative work will be done. This one is basically plus or maximum work. When the work will be done and it will be negative, it is when the force and displacement are opposite to each other. What are the examples? Gravitational force. Gravity is acting downward and you are displacing any object inside gravitational force in upper direction. So you are doing some work against the gravitational force. So the angle between F and displacement will be 180 and you will use negative sign while calculating the answer. Another example is work done due to frictional force. Frictional force acts in the opposite direction of the displacement. So that's why the angle between the two is 180 degree and the negative sign is used. What about the other one? If third one, zero work is done. When it will, it is possible when you are asked to move any desk, chair or any object to the your right or the left side. So you stood up at the surface of that desk, you stood up at the surface of the chair. Anyone asks you, what are you doing? Basically, you say that I'm applying some force. He will say, no, you can't do work. Why? Because you are applying force at an angle that is 90 degree with the displacement. So it is not possible. Mathematically, again, it is proven that no amount of work will be done if there is an angle of 90 degree between force and displacement. This one is an example of maximum work done. If you apply the force along this direction, you will be getting maximum amount of work done. But if you are applying force in opposite direction, you will be getting negative. It happens in case of frictional force. It happens in case of gravitational field. And what about the other one? If the force between angle, if the angle between force and displacement is 90 degree, then no amount of work will be done because you will be unable to produce displacement in the body. So here it is. Assignment to think, observe the work done surrounding in everyday life and make a chart. You have to see in the surrounding. Whenever you get up, you see outside, you see when you're walking, when you're playing football, when you're doing any types of exercises, you're playing games, some types of thousands of examples are there where some amount of work is done. You have to jot down it. You have to make a list of the work. Demonstrate work is a scalar or vector quantity. I have already explained that the work is a scalar quantity because at the end, we don't know the direction of the work. So all the given examples in the book, you have book and there are some examples in the book. You have to solve that example. So here it is. If you look at one problem, that is a man has pulled a cart through 25 meter applying a force of 300 Newton. Find the work done by the man. So this is the amount of displacement covered. This is the amount of force applied. So if you look at, you are asked to calculate the amount of work done. You will put the values of force, the force, and then you will put the value of the displacement, and then you will multiply these two. You will be getting the total amount of work done. To calculate work done, what you need displacement, you need force acting to produce such displacement. Then at the end, you will multiply these two quantities, and you will be getting a work amount of work done. So here is another example. A block weighing 20 Newton is lifted 6 meter vertically. Calculate the potential energy. This is also amount of work done, and we will discuss during our next classes. I thank you all for your patience. Hope you people have enjoyed this class and you have understood how to calculate work done. During this class, we have calculated, we have understood, we have written the formula of the work, we have written the definition of the work, and we have explained in detail the work is a scalar or a vector quantity. And then we have explained what are the basic conditions to do some work. So on what the fact of the work done depends. If there is displacement, then amount of work will be done. If there is no displacement, no amount of work will be done. If there is no force acting, no amount of displacement occurred means no force is acting. And if the angle between two force and displacement is 90 degree, it will be no amount of work done. When the force is acting along the direction of the displacement, maximum work is done. When the force is acting opposite to the displacement, gravitational force or frictional force, negative amount of work is done. But if the angle between the two is 90 degree, no amount of work will be done. So this was our today's task. I hope you people have understood it. Thank you very much for your patience.